never there. And there's one thing I would like you to know. We are not in this world by chance. We are here for a purpose. None of us is here by chance. Whether you believe it or not, you're not here by chance. If you're supposed to be here by chance, you will not be the one sitting here. You will not be the one sitting here. Liberia got two bad news. And all those bad news, I don't want to mention them, but you are still alive. That means God have a purpose for you. So if you're going to sit here and talk to your friend, like when I was in school, my teachers always says, your face looks like someone who is smart, but you are dumb. And it got to a point, because the teachers continue repeating the same thing to me, I accepted it. So when I come to a gathering like this, I'll be talking to my friend around the corner, around. Like, I don't care, because I'm dumb. I'm here for nothing. I'm useless. That's what my teachers call me, useless. And it got to a point, my mom called me and says, what is wrong with you, Sam? How come you're not passing the subjects that you used to love? How come you're not studying? What's wrong? And I was proud to tell my mom, Mom, don't worry about it. The teacher says I'm what? I'm down. So teachers, this goes to you. There's none of these children here is down. None. None. None of these kids sitting down here is down. It's here by chance. They're all here for a purpose. Probably they haven't seen what they're here for. That's why they're walking around, still searching. But it doesn't make them dumb. So if you've been telling them, or if you've ever said it, or you made your mind to say it one day, please, don't ever say it from today. And student, clap for your teachers, they're not going to come. I hope you understand where I'm coming from. The reason why I flew all the way from Australia to this country, Liberia, is on one thing, because I believe we are all in this world for a particular purpose. And none of us is here by chance. It's just we need a little bit of water to germinate beautifully. And that is what I'm doing now. Just telling you that you can achieve it if you want to. But one thing you need to do is to believe in yourself. So I got this on me. It says I believe in you. So I believe in everyone here. Because flying from Australia to here, from Australia to Dubai is 14 and a half hours. From Dubai to Ghana is almost 8 hours. And Ghana to here is 1 hour, 15 minutes. So if I'm here and you don't believe it, what should I tell you? And you don't believe yourself from today. Whose fault? You know that in this world there's a place that every country got it. Even it goes to a point every community have it. It's the richest place in this world. The most richest place. That's where you can find everything that is no use. All the gold, everything is there. And where is it? If you know, just raise your hand up. The richest place in the world and the richest place in Liberia is there. And sometimes even it's in the community. It's the most richest place. When you go there, you will find everything that hasn't been used. And what is it? If you know, raise your hand. Oh, don't. I'm not your teacher. I'm just here. Yeah, so don't feel shy. What is it? Oh, where are you raising your hand? Alright. If you know, don't feel shy. I'm not your teacher. I'm not holding a cane. I'm like this. Because I'm like this. So when the police stop you, you just do it like this because you don't have any weapon. So that's what I do. I'm like this. So I don't have a cane. I'm not here to beat you. And I don't believe this question is wrong. This answer is right. There's nothing like that. We all have different opinions about things. So I believe in that. What is it?
Sous-solé.
Pardon?
Sous-solé.
Sous-solé. that?
Swaziland.
Oh, Swaziland. Sorry. Swaziland. Yeah, Swaziland have it, but the thing, Liberia also have it. Yeah. We have it here.
That's it, the talents?
Yeah, you got talent. And you're getting close though. That thing, when you go to this talent thing, the richest place in Liberia, the richest place in the world. All right, to cut a long story short, it's a cemetery. Cemetery. Yeah. You know it's the richest place in the world. Do you know that? Oh, you don't know? It's the richest place in the world. You know why? Because there are some people who came to this world, they never think from here. They never use their talent. And imagine you are lying on your sick bed and your talent is telling you, you see what you've done to me. You never used me and now you're dying, so I need to die with you. How would you feel if you're on your sick bed? Are you going to say, oh, you know, I was born in Liberia. Liberia is poor. You know, nothing is happening. That's why I didn't use my talent. And you know, my teachers was calling me dumb and I left her. So is that what you're gonna tell your talent? When you're on your sickbed, you're about to die. There are people who died with those things. And I know from today, you're not going to die without making a mark on the wall. Leaving your name. Who knows his great-great-grandfather? We don't know. Grandmother? We will not know. Even some people don't even know their father, like me. I never knew my father. So that's how it is. But, you know, we need to leave a legacy. We are here to make a mark on the wall. None of here is passing through. If you don't make a mark on the wall, it means in your life you've been passing through. I hope when I mention someone like Nelson Mandela, we all know Nelson Mandela, isn't it? He leave a legacy. He make a mark on the wall. He fought a fight that nobody wants to do it, but someone needs to do it. And I'm here to tell you, if none of you guys, or if anybody hasn't done it before, you'll be the first person to do it. And it's possible. I hope we don't know Barack Obama, yeah? We don't know Barack Obama, or do we? Or we know Barack Obama, yeah? Who knows Barack Obama? Who knows where he's from? I'm not listening to you talking behind. If you know, just raise your arm up, I'll call you. Alright, thank you. He's the former president of America. Officially, Barack Obama is the president of America. But he's not the former president yet, because 20th January 2017 is when he's gonna be officially former president. But from now, he's still the president. Donald Trump is just the elected president. And who knows where he's from? His father from?
Kenya.
Kenya. And where's Kenya? In Africa. So, imagine someone's dad from Africa. He went to America to study. He had a kid in Hawaii. The kid grew up in Chicago. And one day Barack Obama and his dad was driving past White House. And we all know White House is where the president lives in America, isn't it? Yeah, we love America. It's a land of opportunity. And Barack Obama said to his dad, Daddy, you see this beautiful house? I can see myself living there one day. And the dad said, what? This is not for ordinary people. Imagine Kenya accent. This is not for ordinary people now. It's for the president. And he says, yeah, daddy, I understand. My teacher told me the president lives in White House, and I said to myself, I want to be a president one day. And the dad says, you're not serious, are you? And he says, no, I'm serious. And he says, have you ever seen in your life, or have you ever heard a black person to be a president in America? Have you ever seen it? He says, no. And he says, Daddy, I can be the first black person to be the president in America. And his dad said, no, hey, son, this conversation is over. I want to think. And this is what our parents and our friends have been doing to us. When we tell them our dreams, instead of them encouraging us, telling us it's possible, they will tell you, man, I don't have your time. And Barack Obama never gave up. Because he said to himself, he wanted to be a president. And what happened? He became the first black president, isn't it? Yes. So whatever you say to yourself today is what you're going to reap tomorrow. So if you've been saying things that you shouldn't be saying to yourself, that's why you are here now. You are who you are because of what you think, the things you say to yourself, the actions you take, makes you who you are. So, I would like to ask the last question before I conclude my conversation with you guys. In this world, we came to this world, God gave us something. And we all have it. If you don't have it, you can't survive. But that thing can make you rich or poor. And what is it? If you know, just raise your hand. You don't need to talk to your friend. Because your friend doesn't know. If he knows, you will raise his hand now. What's your name? Christian. Alright, Christian. Your gift. That thing got a gift. That thing that God gave you got a gift too. Talent. Yeah, that thing can give you a talent. It's got a talent. Knowledge. That thing got knowledge too. Why, both of you want to say knowledge? Wow. Are you twins or what? All right, so knowledge, talent, that thing got it. But it's one thing, we all have it. And if brain, yeah, that thing got brain. Destiny, that thing got destiny. All right, raise your right hand up like this. Raise your right hand up like this. We all got hands, yeah? We got hands, yeah? Raise your right hand up. Put it to your head. We all go head. And that's it. God gave us head. Who have no head? Raise your hand if you don't have a head. Have you ever seen someone with no head talking to you? Have you ever seen it? So if we are poor and we think Liberia can never prosper, who's poor? It's our fault. If we think we are dumb, we can't make it in life, whose fault? So, this head that you point to is your biggest notebook in the world to survive. It's your biggest notebook in the world to survive. So, this is your head here. That round. I know my head is big. My friends used to tell me, oh, you got a big head. I understand. But the head doesn't matter how big is it or small it is. What is in his head is in your head. It's the same thing. But it's just, you got different ways of coming out. You need to bring it out. No one will do it. But what I'm doing is I'm just showing you who you are. Don't limit yourself to Liberia. Don't limit yourself to this school. Aim high, because it's possible. It's possible. You need to aim high. So this is your head here. It's divided into two. You got LB. I hope those there will see, but if they can't, they can see it later. is your head here. This is what is inside your head. So, there's two brains we got. We all got two brains, which is like this, divided like that. So let's say here is 51 and 49. All right, so we all got two brains. None of us here got one brain. None of us. So if you believe that you're dumb, it's your fault. Because you got two brains. God is a perfect God who does perfect things. Because when you were a Christian and you read the Bible, it says, at the end of creation, God saw everything was good. Isn't it?
Yeah.
He called the things out. Let there be light, and there was light. But with you and me, he says, let's make man in our own image. So if we are the image of God, I think every good thing comes from heaven. That's what John said. So why do we always think negative? Why do we always think it's not possible? Are we the children of devil? Someone will pray and says, God, please, don't let me fail my exams, because I hope I won't fail. You will fail, because that's what you're telling yourself. So, let's go back to the board. Having more left brain is what we have in Africa education. We call it education, but those out there, they call it schooling. So you're doing schooling. But it comes with education as well. But education can be outside. The problem with we Africans is that everybody needs to be in a form like this to make sure that the person is educating him or herself. But education should be like, let's say you are an farmer. An agric officer came with a new product and teach you how to plant it. It's an education. Learning how to walk when you were a kid. Sometimes you fall down, your mom says, now get up. How many times did you fall down? Couple, yeah? Did your mom say, no, stop, enough. Don't worry yourself walking. I'll buy you a wheelchair. Whose mom said that? So, you see, how come when we were kids, our mom encouraged us to do things? But it got to a point, they would teach you how to walk. But when you start running, they will tell you to sit down. So that's how